Wayne's been talking about your basketball instincts as being extraordinary for a rookie. We see it. Where do you think they come from, given your rather unusual path to the NBA?
I have no idea. I don't know. Like, I mean, I guess both my parents like were athletes. I was always like in love with like sports in general. I was always like playing around, playing basketball as a little kid. But it's really, like you said, it's just instincts. I don't know where it's coming from. Yeah. I just feel comfortable out there, and I feel like I know where I'm supposed to go.
Yeah, Dwayne's talking about Larry Kostolyak being a really good coach in that regard, to give you the intricacies of the game.
He definitely is. I think I had already had that before I got to Utah, but it definitely improved. Like, I made another step there at Utah, like knowing my positioning and stuff like that.
The fact that Larry was an NBA coach and an NBA player, would that have helped, do you think?
It definitely helped. It helped during my time there. Like, he could help me with his experience, and like in drills and stuff, he knew what was going to happen on at the next level here in the NBA. And then also when I made my decision to go enter the draft, like, he helped me out a lot with what's going to come at me in the pre-draft, and also when I get to the NBA.
Was there another big at Utah that had an influence on you that way?
Well, when I first got there, Dallin Baczynski was there. He was just
Canadian kid.
Yeah, he was a big body. Like, he was a senior. Like, he knew the college game, so he really helped me get adjusted to the U.S. Like, playing college, playing a different style of basketball, like getting more physical. That was really helpful. And then after that, I mean, I got to give some credit to Jace Johnson also, because my second year he was just all over me in practice, you know, like, he was a young kid coming in, just being super aggressive, kind of pushed me to go harder in practice, and I think that helped me too.
Hey, you, sorry.
I'm not done yet. Case is talking about the trust that you've earned. When did you feel you earned that? Like, was there like a moment where this year, or?
I wouldn't say there's a moment. Yeah. It's just, trust is something you got to develop over time, and just like with solid performances, like night in, night out, like that's how you earn your trust. Like, being in the right spots in defensive rotations, like doing your job, playing hard. I feel like that's how you earn a coach's trust, and that's what I tried to do.
You picked up the NBA game pretty quick compared. Like, usually it's a longer progression. Where do you think, like, is it the time in the D League? Is it the time sitting on the end of the bench watching, or is it the time actually getting in those few minutes that you've been able to get into a game?
I think the most helpful was like the actual playing time in the NBA. It's just like learning from experience is definitely the biggest part, but even like you said, from watching at the bench, and D-League is a whole different experience, but it also helps, like, because you all of a sudden it's a little bit like college again, where you have to take on more responsibilities and like get a run in and like, get out there and play. It's a whole different story, but it's still like very helpful, like getting more comfortable out there.
What's been the biggest adjustment to the NBA? Is it the speed, the physicality, something else that stands out?
I want to say it's the physicality. Like, that was definitely not now anymore, because I feel like I'm used to it already. I'm still not the most physical player, but at least I got adjusted to the new level of physicality in the NBA. But that was definitely a challenge to start the season, like getting used to playing against bigger bodies and stronger guys.
Yeah, how come you don't lose your mind when you get the third bad foul call every night?
I'm over it. Let's just say it like that.